I do want to ask you about Donald Trump's first year. Heritage Foundation says more accomplishments in Donald Trump's first year than Reagan's first year. Tell me your thoughts after just over a year now.
Well, phenomenal. In fact, I've had people say to me, you know, I thought I liked Trump. I won't say that anymore. I love Trump. Mm. And it's because the word that I use for him is that he's a disruptor. Mm-hmm. He has disrupted something that needed to be disrupted. That's the bubble in Washington, D.C. And he's done it for the better. And he's done it all, Jan, while he's had the full frontal force of a hostile media against him. In fact, you've seen polling numbers that have said that over 90%, in some cases, 95, even 98% of all stories against Donald Trump have been hostile, negative, and most of them baseless. So he's had a very difficult time to progress what he's wanted to do, but it's amazing the turnaround, and especially for issues that believers care mm-hmm. about.
True. Now, in my lifetime, Michelle, I've not seen the polarization left versus right, conservative versus liberal, even liberal versus Christian. I've never seen it so intense as it has been in the last year since the election of November 2016. And again, the onset of what's been called Trump derangement syndrome. You know, I don't care what it's called. The fact of the matter is the left will not accept the results of that election. And the pushback, I've never seen anything like the hatred is palpable.
Right. It's irrational. And I think, again, that is biblical because there are various passages in Scripture that talk about just irrational levels of hatred. We see that between Palestinians and Israelis. Mm-hmm. It's been just irrational hatred coming out of the Arab world against Israel. It's bizarre. But we see it here in the United States too. And all we can know is that the more that we stay with the true plumb line of truth, that brings about the greatest amount of happiness and effectiveness in the world. And I think when we see people hold on to delusions and lies, what the scripture says in Romans 1 is that we are given over to those delusions.
That's true. That's part of some of that comes out of Romans 1, where we're given over to a depraved mind if we reject God. But it seems to me, and my goodness, you were in Washington for, I think, 2007 through 2013-14, which...
For yeah. 8 years, yeah.
But as I perceive things, the left's only purpose right now is obstruction. I mean, they hate the idea of American exceptionalism, and they seem to only want to hurt the American people. And yet nobody on the left can see this.
Well, obstructing legislation from going forward, but destruction is
That's
really
right.
what they've
That's
been
right.
about. And they were swimming along pretty happily. It didn't bother them that under President Barack Obama, there wasn't 1 year where we consistently had 3% level of growth, which is what a nation needs to have. It didn't bother them that we didn't have it. It didn't bother them that black unemployment was skyrocketing. None of those numbers bothered them at all. All they cared is that they were putting forward their, quote, progressive agenda,
right.
which has a lot to do with socialist agendas, and that's all they cared. But now here we have a situation where the Dow Jones Industrial mm-hmm. Average in the stock market has seen, and it was reported today, a 45% mm-hmm. level of increase. So you're seeing the American economy take off like it never has. Over this last year under Donald Trump, there was over a 3% level of growth for the gross domestic product. That means the entire economy has expanded that by that much. And in fact, Jamie Dimon has said that we may have reached 4% yet this year. So we're seeing a real turn in the economy, which means from the lowest person in the United States financially all the way up to the top, all boats are rising. And as a matter of fact, as we're recording this week, Jan, for the very first time, 90% of Americans are going to see an mm-hmm. increase in take-home pay beginning this week. I'm mm-hmm. going to repeat that. 90% of Americans. Those who aren't seeing the increase are the top of the top. Those people are doing pretty well. They're not going to see any increase. But the bottom 90% of Americans, which means just about everybody, is going to see an increase. And what all that means is there'll be more growth, more jobs, more pay incentives. I mean, you've seen that where whether it's Walmart or Apple or Home Depot, corporations all over America, and literally millions of Americans are getting a $1,000 bonus, as well as they're seeing increased amounts of money in their paycheck because of tax cuts, and also the standard deduction is doubling.
You're listening to Understanding the Times Radio. I'm Jan Markell. I have in studio a familiar voice of Michelle Bachmann, and we'll talk about what God has called her to here in the present and the future in just a little bit. I want to play a soundbite. I want my audience to better understand what's known as the deep state, what's known as the swamp. And I want to play a soundbite of Monica Crowley and come back and talk to you about what we've just heard.
Why has the swamp? And remember what the swamp is. The swamp is the ruling class, and it's comprised of the elites on all sides of the political spectrum. Why has it always dominated? We sort of take it for granted. Why has it always dominated despite repeated attempts by noble patriots over many years to try to chip away at its monstrous power? The short answer is that the swamp controls all the levers of power in this country. And they have the capability and the will to destroy anyone and anything that threatens its grip. The swamp is the perfect embodiment of Lord Acton's warning that power tends to corrupt, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. There are so many other adages that we can apply to this epic cesspool of money and power and status and influence, all contributing to the supreme human and institutional corruption that we see in Washington, D.C. It's everywhere. And it's so daunting. It is a tsunami that comes and crushes anybody in its path. It's elected officials on both sides. It's the establishment on both sides. Their staffs, the media, federal bureaucracies, special interests, lobbyists, even some in the deep state who are supposed to only be focused on America's external threats. And even some in law and law enforcement who are only supposed to be interested in applying equal justice under the law, they've all become corrupted. And this ruling class has dined out on this rotten status quo for a long time, until now. Because finally, this country has elected someone not of, by, and for the swamp. Someone who owes them nothing and does not fear them.
Michelle Bachmann, don't you think that sort of summarizes what's happened in Washington in the last year?
Oh, yes. Monica Crowley has nailed it, because the problem is these are civil servants.
Yeah.
And they are insubordinate to what the voters have elected. The voters elected Donald Trump to get rid of Obamacare and do a number of things. And those who are protected by the unions, they're public servants, supposedly, but their union makes them virtually non-fireable. Doesn't matter what they do. We've all heard the story about people in the EPA, for instance, who would come to work, and it's gross, but they'd sit in front of their computer and watch porn all day. And you can't fire those people? I mean, it's unbelievable the way the system is set up. So these people don't care. They don't care who their boss is. They don't care who the president is. If they're a committed leftist, they see that their whole job is to make sure that they turn the country towards socialism. That is corrupt.
How much of the pushback, how much of what Monica just talked about, and she was very clear that it's both sides of the aisle.
It is.
Yeah, Republicans, yeah, Democrats, yeah, et cetera. But how much do Obama holdovers play into this?
Oh, tremendous. I mean, they're protected for life. And so in some ways, I've mentioned to you Valerie Jarrett, who is the senior advisor for President Obama. In some ways, I think that she still is running the country in areas where she can, because the influence that she or other people in the Obama administration, or just leftists in general, they still communicate with people who have jobs that are paid for by your tax dollars, but they can't be fired. So they're insubordinate to the President of the United States, and we'll probably get into this later, but with this whole issue of Israel, once President Obama did the ultimate disruption and designate Jerusalem as Israel's capital and take that phony issue off the table, at the State Department, they were so outraged by what Donald Trump did that they were even asked by reporters, well, how is this going to change the State Department? If someone is born in Jerusalem, will you write on a birth certificate certificate, Jerusalem, Israel? No, we're not going to do that. How about on passports? Will you now put on the U.S. passports, Jerusalem, Israel? No, we're not going to do that. In fact, the deep state said to the reporters, nothing's changed. Well, everything changed. Everything. The President of the United States has the authority to make that designation. And yet, these insubordinates at the State Department have decided, hey, we're the president. We're in charge, not you. So that's exactly the problem that Monica Crowley's describing.
Yeah. You know, I think Americans at this point, they're weary of this endless mantra of Russian collusion, of dossiers.
They should be. They're smarter than the media. It's a fake story, and they see through it. There's not one bit of evidence. It's been like a year and a half.
Yep.
There's nothing there.
I mean, but it seems to point to, I mean, corruption again in high places, et cetera. You know, I find myself, Michelle, I hardly turn the news on anymore because I know the first story is going to be about dossiers and corruption.
It will be if you turn on CNN.
Well,
it's sickening. Foxes. I'm in airports and I watch this nonsense day to night, and it's like, come on already, get a creative thought.
Yeah, I know. So, but that's infected almost all branches of media. There's some truth still online, but you got to go searching for it. You and I know where to go, and a lot of people don't know where to go. So it gets back to this deep state thing again. And again, I think Americans are sick and tired of it. But even the corruption within the FBI, I mean, it's shocking. It's disappointing.
It's more than shocking. Yeah. This really should take people's breath away.
Yes,
it should. When I was in Congress, this is what I saw under the Obama administration was the corruption of the Department of Justice, specifically the FBI and other departments as well. But just think about it. That's really the benefit that the United States has had for years and years. We observe the rule of law, and all people are to be treated equally under the rule of law. We're not a perfect country. It hasn't happened perfectly. Have there been like racial issues where people have been treated differently because of the color of their skin? Absolutely. That's happened. That's an injustice. It has to be rectified. But never have we seen the level of corruption that we saw under the Obama Department of Justice and in the FBI. And now we're finding it out because now these text messages are showing that people who were working hand in hand with Barack Obama. Now get this, the FBI was trying to defeat Donald Trump as president, as a candidate when he was running. And so they made up this fake phony story. Yep. They tried to pretend that Trump was colluding with Russians to throw the election when there's no evidence.